guys, once again welcome back to Ahoy Navigos. Today we are going to discuss about great circle sailing and we'll be solving a live question for you. So we have the question where we'll be finding and naming of initial and final great circle course. So we have a question: find GC distance, that is your great circle distance, initial and final course between. Two versions are given: A, 10 south, 150 west; B, 40 north and 160 east. So let's see how we go ahead with this type of questions. So first we need to find what is the direction of the course. So A to B, you're going from south to north, that is northerly, and from west to east, it is D long is for 50 west, that is 150 west and 160 east. If you will be having the shortest distance between them, that will be 50 west. That is 150 plus 160, that is 310. And if you 360 minus 310, that will be 50. And it's going from west to east, that is northwest. Now we have our GC. You have your equator first. First of all, you need to draw your equator so that you'll be having a better understanding in any type of questions. So draw your equator. Now we know you have initial at 10 degrees south and north. So we'll be going from south to north, that too in westerly direction. So our course will be somewhat like this: from south to north, westerly. So this is the direction. This being A, initial point. This being B, your final point. Now we know all GC courses will be having a pole. So there will be, this will be your pole, connecting to your pole. So now you formed your spherical triangle for your GC course. So this is how you will be solving. You need to always selecting your pole. So the question is, how will we select which pole to consider? So what thing you need to do is, whichever latitude is higher, that is the pole you need to select. This means you having your north latitude as 40, that is higher. So you select your highest latitude pole. So that means here we'll be selecting north pole. So now let us see. This will be your angle P. That is nothing but same as your D long. We know what is D long. D long is your arc of equator or angle at the poles contained between two meridians. So that is also angle at the poles. So the D long is also your angle at pole, that is 50 west. Also, you know, from equator to pole is 90 degree and from equator to A is 20 degree. Similarly, from equator to this pole is 90 degree and you know this latitude. From equator to B, you know that is 40 north. So from B to pole will be 90 minus 40. There will be 50 degrees here. And in this case, P to equator is 90 and you know 10 degree. That is the latitude of A from equator. So that will be total 100. So we go to the two sides also. And you know, if we need to solve a spherical triangle, you need two sides and one included angle that we have now, that we already discussed in another video about spherical triangle. You can watch it for your reference. So now we have 50 and 100. So now let's find each. What first we need is your GC distance. So for that, and you have these angles of here. This is angle B, this is angle P, and this is angle A. So now first thing what we need to find is GC distance. That is nothing but your distance from A to B, that is side AB. If you find this side of great circle track of this spherical triangle, you will get the great circle distance. So that now you have your ship at your final position like this. This will be your heading of your ship at your final position B, and this will be your ship at initial position A. So in this case, we'll need to find what is your initial and final course. The main thing what you need to consider is that your course is always named from your north meridian on that position towards the north pole and your heading. That means in this case, this is your north meridian and this is your heading, and is always clockwise. These three things are very important. Now you have Your initial course will be from your meridian, as I said, to your heading clockwise. So if you draw like this, you will not be having any confusion. Draw your ship at those position, and from your north meridian towards your heading clockwise, that will be your initial course. Similarly, your final course will also be from your meridian, north meridian, to your heading clockwise. So let's see how we name this ahead. First, we'll calculate with this example what is AB. For that, we have your cos formula, that is cos P is equal to cos AB. Cos P is equal to cos AB, that is your opposite side, minus cos PB, that is your adjacent, into cos PA, adjacent, divided by sine PB into sine PA. This is your equation. Now, when we substitute the values for this, we need to find AB. We know P, we know PB, we know PA. So if you keep AB here, you bring PA, PB and PA here, will be cos P into sine PB into sine PA, plus this will become minus, will become plus here when you transfer it to the other side. So by substituting the values, we can find what is AB, that is your gate circle distance. So you substitute the value, you will be getting the value of AB, that will be cos inverse of whole value, this. So you found AB is equal to 68 degree 4.8. So gate circle distance is always in miles. So you, this is in degrees, so you convert it into miles. For that, AB GC distance is equal to 68 degree 4.8. We found it into 60 to convert it into miles. That will be 4084.8 nautical miles. So this is how we calculate gate circle distance. Now we need to calculate what is the initial and final course. For that, we need to calculate your angle A and also angle B. That will be only known value to find your initial and final course. So your cos angle A will be cos A is equal to cos PB, that is your opposite, minus, this is a cosine formula that we already discussed in another video. I hope you guys understood. If you don't have, you can go to that video and listen to it and come back. Cos PB minus cos PA into cos AB, divided by sine PA into sine AB, that is your adjacent. So you got the value of angle A, that is 39 degree 14.3. Similarly, you need to find angle B. This is angle, cos formula you apply. Cos B will be cos PA, that is opposite, minus cos PB into cos AB, divided by sine PB into sine AB. So you have your angle B also now. You found your angle B value, that is 125.35.5. You're done. Now you need to find what is initial course and final course. We only found angle A and angle B, but we need to find what is initial and final course. For that, we already discussed in another video how to determine this initial and final course with North Pole, South Pole, and this is North Pole situation. So in this case, you see this North Pole, this is your course, what we said. So you know this angle. So the total is 360. So if you minus from 360 this A, you can find this. That will be your initial course. So in this case, your initial course is 360 minus A, that is 320.45.7. Then now you need to find what is your final course. This blue is your final course. That means your north meridian to your heading. What you found is this angle B. And we know this is a straight line, that is a GC line. So the angle from between in this line will be 180 degree. So in this case, your final course will be B plus 180. If you draw this diagram, you know, never be confused about how to do your naming of initial and final courses. So this will be final course will be 180 plus B, that is your 180 plus B, that will be 305.35.5. Another thing you need to notice is that you never write your course in quadrantal course. It will be always in three number notations. So write it as it is, and we will write the answers this way. So this is how you guys, we solve great circle sailing. I hope you guys understood. If you have any doubt, put in comments. We'll get to you. This is Ahoy Navigo signing off. Thank you.